Hello, I'm glad to see you.
I recently created a video for you about precision bubble levels. To test amples of precise bubble levels, an appropriate stand was assembled. It was an interesting video. During the filming process, I learned a lot about the behavior of bubble amples and the limits of their capabilities. With minor modifications, this stand can be used to test autocollimators. Therefore, today I, having somewhat adapted it to the new function, am testing the autocollimator on it.
Sometimes you hear a goose quack, sometimes he sits here, under the window and quacks from time to time so that I don't forget to pour grain for him. I've covered the window with boards. We don't need too much light for this. The stand is a rigid support with a 1000 mm straight edge on top. Granite blocks are glued in certain places to prevent movement. To control the immobility of the left edge, a micron comparator is installed. The right edge can be raised or lowered, controlled by a micro lift, and the movement is executed and monitored with an accuracy of approximately a tenth of a micron. I carefully turn the micro lift disc and control the ascent or descent very precisely. I've placed the autocollimator's mirror on the straight edge, installed the autocollimator opposite it, and now I can check how accurately the autocollimator works, whether its readings correspond to real changes in the mirror's tilt angle, and what the limit of the autocollimator's precision is. To allow you to see everything for yourselves, I've adapted a video camera to the autocollimator's eyepiece. It took a lot of effort to shoot the video with sufficient quality. I spent almost 2 weeks trying various filming methods, adapting the camera for this task, and developing a way to process the obtained video. It's significantly more complex than it might seem at first. For instance, moving parts in the camera's autofocus system, which don't affect the quality of regular video recording, unpredictably caused minor image shifts, breaking the required image stability. Tiny movements of the lens or sensor are unacceptable here. But in the end, I achieved a pretty good result. Under certain conditions, the camera can see better than our naked eye. Through the camera, in 4K resolution and with maximum zoom, I was able to monitor the autocollimator's readings twice as accurately as with the naked eye. As a result, the autocollimator with a sensitivity of 0.5 arc seconds saw changes in the mirror's tilt angle with an approximate resolution of 0.25 arc seconds. The lens quality handles this perfectly. It's worth noting that in the USSR, consumer goods were typically of low quality due to the specific socialist industrial organization. However, the production of measuring instruments was carried out with the utmost precision by highly qualified specialists. To accomplish this task, the best Western equipment was acquired without sparing expenses. This was essential for the development of the Soviet military-industrial complex. Without this, the rockets wouldn't have made it into space. By watching this video, you can form an understanding of the accuracy of this instrument and its limits, including what these limits are constrained by. I simplified the design of the stand by accurately adjusting the comparator simply by turning it in a loose mount and applying some force up or down. So, everything is ready. I turned on the camera and step by step raised the straight edge by 1 micron, giving the mirror time to settle from vibrations caused by my hands' movements controlling the rise of the right edge of the straight edge. This process takes about 5 seconds. For this experiment, I used a comparator with a resolution of 0.5 micron, which allows me to quite accurately control the movement of the right edge of the straight edge. The expected error in this movement is plus or minus 0.1 micron. In this experiment, that's entirely acceptable. I will further process the obtained video footage to create a visual representation.
-21.
Now, look at the final result. This instrument is perfectly focused, and the image, crosshair, and scales are clear. I'm raising the right edge by 1 micron step by step, and each time, I see a change in the position of the crosshair reflected by the mirror. This autocollimator with a sensitivity of 0.5 arc seconds should be able to detect changes of 2.5 microns at a meter, but with the camera's use, I was able to see even a single micron. Additionally, I repeat the most interesting place, a little up and down from the center, you see a change in position, even by 1 micron. Really noticeable. I'll also check the correspondence of the instrument scale readings to the actual changes in the mirror's tilt angle. For this, I need another mechanical comparator with lower sensitivity. One with a sensitivity of 0.01 millimeters will do. Moving the right edge of the 1000 mm straight edge up or down by 0.29 mm with its left edge remaining fixed should correspond, according to calculations, to a change in the mirror's tilt angle of 1 arc minute. I will carry out this movement and check whether it accurately reflects on the instrument scale. Through this test, I will have grounds to trust the readings of this specific instrument and consider it suitable for use. Again, I set the scale to 0 and change the mirror's tilt angle by 1 arc minute, raising the right edge by 0.29 millimeters. The test confirms the accuracy of the instrument's readings. So, the instrument has been tested and is ready for sale. I had already found a suitable autocollimator for my workshop. By the way, I will also check its accuracy. Accordingly, it is also placed on the stand. Here's what the result looks like. I also have an instrument with a sensitivity of 1 arcsecond in stock. It was purchased from me by an enthusiast of such devices from Poland, but it's appropriate to test it before shipping. Although its sensitivity is 1 arcsecond, it can already detect 3 microns per meter, and consequently, its sensitivity is undoubtedly visible. The buyer intends to scrape the bed of a 2-meter lathe, and this device will allow him to fit within the permissible error of up to 6 microns, if he makes an effort. A rigorous approach to conducting the experiment requires checking the micrometer itself. This task is also feasible, but perhaps another time. I want to finish this video quickly and get to making a 1-meter ruler and a 1-meter mirror stand for the 3-meter guide of the surface grinder repair project. These tools will be made using the same bench that you saw in this video, after some modifications.
I want you to understand me correctly. I am asking for support through Patreon, not because I can't find a way to make a living. I have my own small business. I make clothes. I have my own workshop, equipped with the appropriate equipment. But I want to work less in my sewing workshop and more in my metalworking shop, making videos for you. Because I think this work is more useful for you and more interesting for me than clothing production. I am very grateful to those who were willing and able to support my project.
Thank you for your attention. Support through subscription, Patreon, likes. Goodbye.